Hey, Yetta, you know, I think I love crisis.
Are you sick?
Moving forward with the Dekker Team. Moving forward together with the Dekker Team.
We're excited and thrilled, actually, that we've been able to create for you free access to over 603 Life's Inside Track episodes, where we share insider tips, making house home, how to get the most out of what you're up to in the world, and leveraging is part of that conversation. And the great news is you can get access to them from anywhere you would like, including our YouTube channel. So you know what to do. Turn us off and then go subscribe. No, that's not what they're supposed to do. What we're actually going to do is go on an exploration. We're going to go on an exploration that during crisis, there just may be the best opportunity ever.
Yeah, I think there's more opportunity. You know, in I've heard it said that in the Great Depression, in the late 20s, that more millionaires were made. And a millionaire back in the 20s was a huge deal. Like it's probably like 100 million now, right?
Right.
Equals
it's
dollars
a different,
for dollars.
Yeah, yeah. It's a different conversation.
There were more millionaires made then than most periods.
Right. So I think the part of the message here is people feel, and I know I felt that way, that when times are tougher, that's not the time to actually go out there and look for opportunities. That's the time to sort of shore things up and keep things safe. And if you've already been keeping things safe and secure and building equity and having excess, this may be the time to access some of it because the opportunities are even bigger than they will be at other times.
Yeah, I agree. When there is uncertainty, when there is financial stress, when there's pressures because of higher interest rates, people need to make decisions to liquidate properties that maybe they wouldn't make under different circumstances. For someone that's well positioned to take advantage of that, and you're not taking advantage of the person because the person is choosing to sell at the price they're selling. It's you're making a decision to take advantage of the opportunity.
Right. So even if it feels unrealistic, it might not be when you look at the, we're going to say, four or five ways that we've been chatting about that you can find ways to leverage without hurting anyone and, in fact, helping someone. Mm-hmm.
So the first one is maybe leverage family. Mm-hmm. You know, recently we helped somebody buy a home. It was a little out of their price range, but the value they bought was significantly bigger than if they'd stayed in their price range. And so a family member said, hey, you know what? I'll loan you or I'll be partners with you, basically. Here's a bunch of money. You don't have to pay any payments on it. And when you sell the property, I'll take a small portion of the increase along with my investment.
Right. So
it's a win-win for both of them.
Absolutely. Because in that case, the person that was giving the money actually felt so secure because they know the character of the people they were giving it to. Mm-hmm. So they know they're going to get the money and it's a way better rate of return in the big picture than they would be looking at if they just put it even in a decent 5% guaranteed rate of return because of the way the tax implications are, all of the different things that we've been talking about.
And they're helping out a family member.
And they're helping somebody. And I just want to kind of put a little bow around what Ken said. Because they went up in price range, they got a much better value for what, like they got better value on the dollar. It wasn't only that they went up in price range. It was because there was nothing in the price range they were in that had been on the market long enough and had started too high and was now an exceptional value that suited them. Mm-hmm. And so by looking up in the price range, we found the red herring, if we want to call it that.
The unicorn, the needle in the haystack, the needle whatever in the you want to call it.
Whatever
that's
you want
what
call
I was
it.
Looking for.
That's what we were looking for. So by going into the next price range, we found four properties, actually, that were considerations that had been priced way too high for the market and now were priced significantly below the market. So the day they moved in, even with our current values, they were conservatively looking at a $40,000 increase in the value. I mean, the appraisal is still not going to come in at the higher price and whatever. But the reality is, if they wanted to turn it around, they actually could in this case.
Yeah, minimal.
Minimally.
Yeah. So now another, you know, recently I found some great properties out of town, because in town, in Ottawa, very hard to get cash flow, positive cash flow. Almost impossible. Almost impossible.
Almost. Once in a while, there's again another red herring.
Yeah, but they're tough.
They are.
But if we go outside, you know, Carlton Place, Cardinal, Prescott, Brockville, you may find an investment property that's still positive cash flow, even at interest rates of, you know, 6.75 or 7%. So that's really cool. And we recently found a couple we're negotiating on. So there's that. And then I looked at, okay, who's the owner? And in this case, it was under power of attorney. Now, power of attorney tells me something about someone's situation, right? Either they're ill, can't make decisions on their own, or they're out of country and they're trying to liquidate. So it gives me an indication of motivation and all that without really knowing much.
Right. And so that's leveraging a situation that, again, as Ken said, you didn't create it. We didn't create it. We're actually helping the person by helping them get out of a situation that isn't serving them anymore.
Exactly.
Right? It may have served them at one point, but it's not doing the job anymore. So if you're thinking, I want in on some of these, well, email us. You know what to do. Together at DeckerTeam.com, because we promise not only to stay connected between Life's Inside Track episodes, but to give you access to opportunities that we can't just share with everybody. We can only share with those that we are caring for and representing and on the journey with. Mm-hmm. So we want to make sure you know that these stories we share aren't just for those people. They're also for you.
Yep. Now, we might look for a property that we can do a vendor take-back mortgage at a lower interest rate to make something work properly, for the transaction to work. We look for properties that have excess land. You know, a few years back, we bought that little small apartment building in Cardinal. And now we have some extra space on it, and we're looking at possibility of building another building on it.
Yeah, not like the land has, right, excess land. Mm-hmm. And then zoning. Right. Is the zoning now something that isn't the best for that particular property? And maybe by changing zoning, and it's allowed to be changed in many cases, if that's the case, does it all of a sudden make it more valuable because you can do more with it?
And sometimes even the zoning allows, say, a 4-unit only has a 1-unit on it.
Right.
Zoning's already there. So, you know, the potential is higher. That's an opportunity. You know, maybe it's got ability to sever the land and you can sell off the piece of land and keep the asset. And the asset doesn't generally go down very much if you're selling off excess land.
We have clients right now that we've been encouraging them from the beginning, because that's one of the things we look at when we go talk to a seller. Is there an opportunity here for you to do something to get more value before we even sell it?
Right. So I believe opportunities abound if we're just looking for them and we're patient. And together, we're clarifying your options, because when we do, your wisdom will flow.
Moving forward with the Dekker Team. Moving forward.